Hey, are you subscribed to LTSS TV?
No.
What?
Hey, did you know there is a Lord Tweezmer YouTube channel? You should go check it out. On the channel, you can find sports, drama, Eye of the Panther, tutorials, Tweety Idol, and special events.
That's right, folks. Take Your Kid to Work Day is right around the corner. Start thinking about where you'd like to go. Ask your parents, ask your friends, ask your friends' parents. While you're at your workplace, make sure to fill out the Take Your Kid to Work Day student questionnaire. And feel free to ask the employee you're following any questions you have. Make sure to hand in your questionnaire before November 7th.
Before you start thinking about skipping, Take Your Kid to Work Day is mandatory for all grade 9 students, but if you have no one to be brought with, you will have to go to the library and fill out a work booklet.
Football.
Let's go. They want to know if he can rap or tell him really. Tell my call me me because I done finally got a million. Let's go. You know I like that when they get pretty. Like to turn it down, that's how I act when I get jiggy. Look around and tell him no, I want to switch, huh? We out of backwoods. Get a switch.
What did you think about the bio game?
Well, I thought it was great. Kids played a great football game, but really, you know, the bio game is about raising some money for a good cause, and I really appreciate all the teachers who had their kids buy out and made an appearance out there on the field. It was great to see everybody come together for a great cause, and you know, October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month, and we wanted to do more than just pink, and it was a coordinated effort to raise some money, and thanks to the different leaderships in this school who stepped up and helped make that an event a success.
Shout out to all the students who donated for the bio game and for supporting the team. All donation went toward the Canadian Cancer Society, and shout out to Mr. Thornton for the donation idea.
Trades Expo.
The Grade 8s have a field trip on October 24th to the Agriplex for a Trades Expo. You'll be walking to and from the Agriplex with your Block A teacher. At the Expo, you complete a Trade Expo package and hand it in to your Block D teacher. Permission forms due October 18th with your Block A teacher.
Grade 12 boat cruise. Oh no, I think I'm getting seasick.
1, 2, 3, take my hand and come with me because you look so fine that I really want to make you mine. Really want to make you mine. 4, 5, 6, come on and get your kicks. Now you don't need the money when you look like that, do you, honey? Big black boots, long brown hair. She's so sweet with her. Get back there. Well, I can see you home with me.
The federal election.
On October 17th and 18th, Mr. Fournier will be holding a mock federal election. On the 17th, it's for the humanities classes only, but on the 18th, anyone can come. If you want to win prizes and you want to get volunteer hours, go see Mr. Fournier.
Mock federal election is a student vote, a chance for students at our school to look at the candidates for the upcoming federal election and make an informed decision on which candidates they feel would best represent them and their constituency. So a good way for students to get to know the candidates is to come and have a look at these folders here around the school. You'll see in the folders a quick little rundown of each candidate and what they stand for and their parties. so that they can make, like I said, an informed decision on who will best represent them. And we'll compare our results to the results of the grown-ups in our community and see where we stand.
Spooky stories.
Hey, Jacob.
Hey, do you want to scare the absolute heck out of someone? Well, then you should enter the Scary Stories Contest. Once upon a time, I held the mic normally. So scary. The story must be no more than 140 characters long. You could submit it to your English teacher or Mr. Ferrier when you're done. The due date is October 24th. For more info, see Mr. Ferrier in room C202 and follow at @LTSS_EnglishDep. Oh, you thought that was scary? Well, this next clip is terrifying.
It's time for another episode of A Moment with everybody's favorite guy named Maya.
Hello there, and welcome back to A Moment with Miles, where today we're going to be interviewing some of the administrators way up in the office there on what kind of costumes we should be wearing for Halloween coming up. Let's go see!
So, today I'm here with...
Mr. Goodman.
And Mr. Goodman, can you tell me about the dress regulations for Halloween this year?
We encourage all the kids to wear costumes. Of course, there are some rules. They're in our code of conduct, the same rules that apply for attire. Drug and alcohol messages, of course, are prohibited. Profanity, anything that is demeaning to any ethnic group. For example, just take a look at our Prime Minister and what he's been in the news for. Anything that covers a student's face is not allowed. Yeah, weapons or props of weapons, of course, aren't allowed either.
Thank you very much. And will you go trick-or-treating with me?
Pick me up at 7.
Very well.
There we go.
See you then. All right, let's go talk to some kids and maybe even an adult on what they'll be wearing for Halloween. Let's go see. And now I'm here with...
Joey.
Tyler.
Mr. Bailey.
What are you going to be dressing up as for Halloween?
Ohio.
Sans.
This guy, Miles Taylor, Moment with Miles. Have you seen it? Big YouTube star.
All I know is that show kind of stinks. Please rise for O Canada.